Why is work a valuable way to, or a valuable point of entry for understanding the history of women in the United States?
Well, look, the sexual division of labor has existed, does exist in every known society, every known society. It's not the same everywhere. So some societies assign women some jobs and men other jobs. You know, there's a great deal of difference among societies. But every society has a sexual division of labor. It's a what we might call a primary mode of social organization. And since it involves both gender and labor, we're talking about the sexual division of labor. Labor work is divided along gendered lines. If we understand gender as a system of power, we surely need to understand how work or labor fits in, modifies, participates in exercising gendered power. An easy illustration of that is the notion of masculinity. We just need to think for a moment about how a manly man can be measured in a variety of ways by his athletic prowess or his strength or military might. But he is also and necessarily measured by how well he provides, how well he provides for his family, how much income he brings in, how much food in a hunter-gatherer society. So it's the work he does is an essential measure of his manliness. How a woman uses that work is a measure of her womanliness. That is, how she, in the 19th century, we would say how she stretches the husband's dollar. The notion that she is dependent on him is a measure of her womanliness and his manliness or masculinity. So we can't really study the history of women or the history of gender without studying the history of work. And in this class, I thought if we took it as the lens through which we actually looked at gender, we would have a clearer picture of how work and gender function together to reinforce each other. So work, of course, also reinforces hierarchical systems of power. The kind of work you do and where you fit into the hierarchy reinforces class relationships. And we know that those also reinforce and play into race relationships. So thinking about them in relationship to gender opens up all kinds of other thoughts and ideas about how it is that social organizations reinforce and intersect with each other.